Access for Everyone, Breaking Down Digital Barriers for People with Disabilities. Topic 4, Vendors and Partnerships.
Whenever you're tackling a new project, teamwork helps. And at the U.S. Department of Education's Office for Civil Rights, we encourage you to build partnerships with other educational institutions to create digital accessibility. What does this look like? Well, let's look at it from the perspective of a fictional college called Sample University. Sample University has realized that its introductory level virtual courses are not accessible to people with certain disabilities. The university has decided to contract with a vendor to create accessible instructional materials for the introductory level virtual courses located on its learning management system. But it has never done anything like this before. So, some of the IT, accessibility, and procurement staff decided to reach out to their counterparts at nearby colleges and universities, and they're in luck. Staff at those schools are also interested in contracting with local vendors to create accessible instructional materials for similar courses. And better yet, they have adopted similar accessibility goals and benchmarks. So these schools decide to partner with each other to share ideas, information, expertise, and knowledge. What a huge help. These schools can now collaborate, thereby decreasing costs and time, and act as a unified partnership to provide more accessible programs and services for people with disabilities. With the partnership established, Sample University reaches out to different digital vendors on behalf of the university and its counterparts. Their research has helped them understand that they need to locate vendors whose products will help meet the group's shared accessibility goals and benchmarks. The university's procurement team wants to make sure they work with a vendor who understands accessibility. So they make sure to discuss the importance of accessibility testing of digital materials and technologies, like manual testing and priority areas for testing, and processes and timeframes for the vendor to resolve accessibility concerns identified by the university. Once the university has a few proposals in hand, they want to make sure the contract includes, among other terms, a clear definition of accessibility and accessibility requirements, including the criteria used to determine the accessibility of the content and the functionality of the vendor's product. A statement that the vendor is responsible under the contract for meeting the accessibility requirements. How the university should communicate accessibility-related concerns to the vendor, including a direct point of contact, and how quickly and thoroughly the vendor is expected to respond to those concerns. And when they evaluate the vendor products for accessibility, they share the results with each other. The university is now all set and excited about their partnerships with other schools and with vendors that will allow them to achieve digital accessibility. So a quick recap. Create partnerships with peer educational institutions and work with digital vendors to ensure they prioritize accessibility the same way you and your partners do.
This video was produced by the U.S. Department of Education Office for Civil Rights.
You can find us at ed.gov/OCR or email us at OCR@ed.gov.